Pull your weight around here, and by pull your weight, I mean you're gonna hold this down with literally your weight. All right, here we go. That's better. I needed to switch gears a little bit today. Bags were getting underneath my skin as I was finishing up the three that I was working on yesterday. So I need to change a little bit, change it up, switch up the process. And by making these three trays, I will make two orders for fulfilled, as well as an extra for myself, really, because I want one. So there we go. I'm very excited about these. This was the one design that I said I want this on the tray. Definitely, most definitely. I need this on a dice tray. Bags going forward will all have labels printed into the fabric, for any custom fabrics at least, which I actually think I'm going to start doing just custom fabric on my dice bags, my keychain bags, because getting it custom printed with the design that I have for it, whatever I want to make it into. It actually really, really helps the process go a lot smoother, because as I'm cutting it and everything like that, I already have the lines there. I don't have to measure and whatnot because I've already done that. So I think I'm actually going to do that going forward. At least for keychain bags for now. Going to make them all face the same way. I think that's a good idea. And then Hello, welcome. Good afternoon. It's afternoon here. So it's not exactly in the middle. But
we're marching forward, we're not gonna retreat. Ain't nobody here afraid of defeat, but we're ready.
sorry. Oh gosh. Eyelash. Gosh. Alright. Right now, I am making Rainbow D20 trays. And I'm measuring out the center part where I'm going to have the, where I'm going to have the middle of the tray be. This is going to be the inside. So I want to make sure that the rainbow part is actually, you know, like, on the middle. So I'm marking it up and looking at it. Okay, as long as I follow that, should be fine. So I'm gonna pick that one. Alright. So yeah, here actually oops. Reach it down slowly. There you go. Now you can see a little bit better. There we go. Wild beast. Alright. Don't worry about this. There's so little room here. Okay. Sorry. Let's continue. I got a little burned out on bags, particularly turning them, and I need to switch processes. I need to switch to a different thing for a little bit. So we're going to do some trays because I should be able to get them at least partially together before my in-laws come and I can finish them later. It kind of, you know, makes you feel good. Besides, one of these is for me. You know, I'm actually making myself something right now, too. Because I wanted a Rainbow D20 tray, like, for myself. It was one of the things that I was like, this is what I want for me. So, we are doing that. Let's match in the middle of 3 and 8, right here-ish. Yes. If anyone should have a rainbow tray, it should be me. I agree. I agree heartily. Rainbow Maker is making herself a rainbow. really exciting. So tired of not being able to see where the line is that I need, so I just went through and marked on my thing because fuck your rules. All right. Thank you. now the question is, what color thread do I use? Yes, this is a very good question. Hold, please. Silver, gold. Silver, because the snaps are going to be silver and I want to match the snaps. There we go. Fred Cam. Hello, Fred. Alright. Let's get these babies started. I guess this one's mine. I want a little crooked there. how's my week going? It was a week. I'm glad it's gone. That's the nicest thing I can say. Well, it's not quite gone, but you know, it's almost done. Yay. Oh boy. Yeah, we're gonna leave it at that. That's a fair assessment. Yep. Obviously, I'm still at work, so that's a thing. But, you know, I have 4 packages downstairs that are ready to be shipped out tomorrow morning. And if I can get these 3 trays done, I have made something for myself, and I have 2 more packages ready to go. So, that's a thing. I'm trying to stay on the bright side. Also, my in-laws are bringing dinner tonight. That's cool. We'll be here in like an hour-ish. So I'm gonna get as much of this as I can done, and we'll see how far I get. Let's go to get here. Obviously, when I get here, I gotta go. Sounds like plenty got done to me. Yeah, plenty did get done this weekend. So that's a good thing. Not nearly as much got done this week as I was hoping. But you know, I'm only one person, so I gotta give myself a little slack. My house is clean, my family is going to be fed soon. We're all healthy-ish. I'm really glad I had these, or I cut these the other day, last weekend, because it really made getting into this project a lot faster. Alrighty. Let's get these marks off. Repin. That's where I want it. I'm actually going to switch to this. This is much better. This is less folly a party than the other one was. On Molly Mock to erase all the past mistakes. Funnier in your head. It's okay. All right, I need one more tag. Like that one. No rushing. There we go. Beautiful. All right. Actually, we need the plug back out. Whoops. Gotta iron again. one could call me the Iron Maiden.
Well, no, I'm not a maiden. At one point, I could have been called the Ironing Maiden. Am I up to date on Critical Role? No. No. I think the last full episode I watched was, the last full episode I watched was episode, like, 3 or 4 of season 2. Sorry. Ironing. Not iron. Ironing.
Whoops. Hold your weight. Thank you.
Ironing Maiden. Iron Matron. There we go. Ironing Matron. Irony Matron. Sorry, not sorry. Irony Matron is your tarot muffins version. Yes. I like this. This makes me happy. You know what else makes me happy? These freaking trays. Look at this. It's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. I'm so excited. For real though, this tray that I'm making right now is the reason why I did the entire pre-order, because I wanted one of these for myself. This is it. Okay, I'm done now. Everybody can have a refund. Just kidding. I'm not done. Totally not done. I gotta finish. I have to finish. It's too fucking beautiful of a line to not. Y'all, I cannot wait until I have one of everything just lined up for everybody to see, because I'm holding on to one of everything, and I will put the entire lineup for everyone to see, and they can say, "Aw, man, I totally missed out." Yes! Yes, you did. You did that to yourself. Bitches! Sorry. Got a little carried away there. Everywhere.
I know. Gotta get you a little lower so you can see what I'm doing.
There we go. There we go. Blood magic. That one fucking hurt. I don't think it was deep enough to actually draw blood. But yeah, there we go. Bloodbending. I like it. Yep. This is gonna be great. I'm so excited. Sorry, I'm a bit quiet today. I'm concentrating on blood bending. Oh yeah, and making these trays too. I'm concentrating on that too. We'd never see the stains on this line because you bleed rainbows anyway. thank you. I needed that one.
trash.
There we go. One down. Oh, my hair is like all the little wispies are just all converging on my nose, and so I keep scratching my nose. That's because I have little wispy hairs coming in and just brushing them ever so lightly. You can't see it, but I have little wispy hairs that float around my face at all times, but they're so fucking blonde that you cannot see them. Damn you, blondness, sometimes. We'll be right back.
Citrus. Yeah, silver was a good idea. Adds a little bit of a sparkle, but it doesn't detract from the colors themselves. Good idea, me. Silver thread? Yes. That's what I used here. It's hard to see, which is kind of the point. I don't necessarily want it to be, like, I don't want the thread to be the central, like, thing you notice on this tray. It's a nice little sparkle, but it doesn't add any color, and it doesn't take away from the colors that you see. So I'm very happy with it.
Messing with the camera. There we go. Fred cam. The trick I just did there to get it through is I kind of backed in and did a little bit of drilling almost with my needle. Is I essentially just went up and down trying to kind of saw my way through the points between the in the spaces between the weave, because it's a very tight weave. That was a spot with a lot of different layers. So I was just kind of like cutting my way through the little bits of weave with my needle. Never force your needle through anything, that's how you get stuck. Like there's a reason why it says, no, can't do that. So what I'm going and doing is I'm getting through little bits at a time. Thank you.
quickest way to break your needle and or your sewing machine is to force your needle through too many tightly woven pieces of fabrics or fabrics that it's not supposed to go through with that type of needle. Really, really fast way to break your sewing machine. Take it from me. I know how to break sewing machines. One tray done sewing. I might be able to make it. Thank you.
two done. Well, that's sewing at least. All right, third. Here, but you totally got it. There we go. It was just Blizzy trying to send a little more chaos everywhere. Do do do. Fred. One last seam. It's not as bad as it seems. Thank you. we go. Now we just gotta put snaps on them and we're good to go. All right, thank you, Fred. Great job today. Next. Exactly what I wanted it to look like. I'm so excited. This is a happy day. Yes. Let's do it. Going. The in-laws are here. It's family time. So I'm gonna finish putting these snaps up as I get off a stream. And these will be done later tonight. Thanks for hanging out. I hope you all have a wonderful evening, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Oh, thank you, Stonefly Kai. Yeah. I'll see you later. Bye.